Bryn Larkin's arrangement of Days of Wine and Roses. It's an awesome thing. Awesome arrangement, man. Well done. If it's alright, I'd like to ask you a couple questions now.
Straight onto it.
Switch on that microphone you got over there.
Hello, hello.
The first question I'd like to ask you, Bryn, is how you first got into music.
Oh, well, it really was one of those cases. You know how people play like classical music to the kids in the womb? Do you know about that?
Yeah.
Okay, no, good. Yeah. Everyone, yeah, okay, so I'm not weird for knowing that. Okay, that's a normal thing to know. Anyway, so for me, instead of Mozart, like it was for a lot of people, it was Pat Metheny. So for those of you who don't know, who are tuning in or who are here, so Pat Metheny is a brilliant guitar player and improviser and composer, just fantastic musician. But yeah, so basically I grew up in a musical family. My dad's a jazz drummer. I think he's watching right now, actually. But they, yeah, I, hey dad. yeah, and I was always music around the house, and mum has great taste in music. She introduced me to a lot of my favourite artists. And she loved Keith Jarrett. There was a lot of Keith Jarrett growing up, and he's still one of my favourite artists. For those who don't know, great jazz piano player and fantastic musician. But it was always around me. I always guess I appreciate it to some degree. But to cut a long story short, because it is a long story of how I really got into it, I was over at my friend Mike's place one day. Mike Ellis, phenomenal guitar player, just one of the greatest that I've ever heard, I reckon. But so a family friend, he's a family friend of ours. His dad and my dad are musos and have played together for a number of years. But I remember I was sitting on the couch tinkering around with guitar, and I'd been playing for like 2 or 3 years at this time, and I was enjoying it, but it was more of a kind of casual thing, I guess. You know, like I did like it, and I was kind of playing a bit, but I just heard this amazing music coming from their little studio area, and I was like, what is that? And I was sure it was a record because it sounded like something I'd heard before, and I walked in and it was just Mike practicing over a backing track or something, and I was just like, I can't believe that's possible. You know, I guess it just like opened my ears and my eyes to that world, and ever since then, I guess I haven't looked back. Yeah.
Were you already playing guitar at that time?
Yeah, for a couple of years. I've been doing classical guitar.
And then you switched over to jazz?
Yeah, to the dark side. Yeah.
Well, that's great. Thank you for that awesome story. Yeah. Mike Ellis, I'm sure we'll get him on here at some stage down the line.
Yeah.
Also from Margaret River. Oh, actually, no.
Australian,
sorry. Yeah.
Well, Harvey originally, but yeah.
But yeah, we'll get him on at some stage. But that's a great story. Thank you very much, Bryn. And what's kept you playing?
Oh, sorry, I turned it off. What's kept me playing? I guess I love music. I think it's a gift from God, and I feel like it's just one of the most amazing things that we can experience as human beings and share with other people. And, you know, it's like, it's the universal language, and you can communicate with people in so many other ways than just through words. And, it's just a beautiful thing to make music and to listen to music and to be around musical people. So, yeah, I just like, I can't imagine doing much else. Yeah,
well, that's a great answer as well. Thank you very much, Bryn, for your insight. I'm looking forward to playing some more of your arrangements here. It's always great to hear how you communicate yourself through music. I think it's a very unique style that you do.
Thank you.
You always have great passion and energy for the music and for life. So I'm happy to have you here, Bryn.
Yeah, happy to be here, Will. Thank you for having me.
And let's crack on with another song. Yeah. This is one of your own songs, I believe.
Yes, it is. I almost turned the mic off again there. So this is a piece entitled Midnight Musings. And there's a running gag because there's a few other musicians in my circles who've written... I think it's just one other guy. Sure. But has written... So there's a bit of a... There may be a bit of copyright issues going forward, but for now it's all good. But yeah, this is a tune I wrote late at night in that creative flow that you tend to get in when you're writing at that time. And so this one's called Midnight Musings.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Thanks very much, guys. That was Bryn Larkin's Midnight Musings. Awesome song, man. I believe the next song we're going to do is a trio song.
Yeah, do you want me to talk about it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hello, I'm on again. Goodbye, Jackie, for now. Yeah, so this piece is one that's very close to my heart, and written by one of my favorite musicians of all time. So this next tune. This next song is a composition by the great and recently late Wayne Shorter. Rest in peace. Yeah. And it's entitled Fall. And I'm assuming that's referring to the season. For those of us who aren't Americans. Yeah. And it's just a beautiful tune. Hope to do it some justice today. And yeah, we're just going to kind of enjoy the harmony in the tune, which is beautiful and rich, like so many of Wayne's tunes. And yeah, and I love the guitar trio format because it's such an intimate setting. And also I get to have all the harmony and I don't get it stolen from me by the piano player. Anyway, so this is Fall by Wayne Shorter.
Thank you.
wonderful song and a great rendition, Bryn Larkin. We're now going to move on to another cool little arrangement you've done of a classic jazz song called Moment's Notice. And if you know the original, this next song might shock you. We have a bit of fun on this one, and it's a cool arrangement. So here we go, Moment's Notice.
One, two, three, four.
was a great arrangement by Bryn Larkin on moment's notice. We've come to the last song of the night, and unfortunately, yeah, it's been great having you. Been listening to Bryn Larkin. Ben Anson on bass. Jackson Van Balagorn on piano. This has been Live at the Bungalow. If you did enjoy it, we hope that you can follow us on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube. We'll be uploading this to YouTube afterwards, and usually the quality is a bit better on there. So if you want to revisit it, please do. And if you feel inclined, we have an online tip jar as well, which helps feed all of us. So I'm actually feeling quite hungry now, so I hope you get some tips. No, thank you very much for tuning in, and thanks everyone for coming down in the house. We had a great time. We're probably going to have a bit of a jam after this, hopefully, if you guys are keen on hanging around. And so we're going to finish off with one last song. Tell us the story of this song,
Brent. Oh, so this song is called The Journey. And I know it's a cliche to write songs and go, oh, this one's about life. This one's about life, you know. This is the journey, you know, the journey through life. But that's kind of what this is. It was also about, you know, it's about kind of overcoming adversity and learning to trust the process, not just in music, but in life and, you know, in, and for me, being a Christian, it requires a lot of, a lot of refining and a lot of reflecting and a lot of, this would pertain to other people too, but I find particularly for me in that path, and this is kind of where this song comes from, is that, that idea of that journey, that kind of spiritual journey as well, and very heavily inspired by John Coltrane and Kenny Garrett and Brian Blade, who are all people I look up to very much. I'm a bit tired. My brain's not working as well as it should right now. But I hope that you get that sense of that kind of sort of, you know, onward and upward and forward kind of momentum in the song that kind of, yeah, that imitates life, I hope. Thanks very much. Yeah.
Thanks very much, Bryn. I'm looking forward to playing. We hope you enjoy. This is the last song. It's called The Journey. And after this, the journey is over. So we'll be switching off the live stream and everyone can go home. So I guess the journey's just begun, really, if you have to go home. But those people already at home, the journey is over. So we're going to play this for you. This is by Bryn Larkin. And then we'll sign off. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much to everyone for tuning in and for coming down. You've been listening to Bryn Larkin on guitar. And some very original compositions by him and arrangements. Ben Anson on bass.
Yeah.
Jackson Van Balagorn on piano.
Yeah.
Thank you. My name is William Chu. You've been listening to Live at the Bungalow. And we'll be back next week with some more music. Thank you so much for tuning in. And we hope you had a good time. Thank you.
Thank you.